Hello guys, and welcome to another episode of Brompton then. So today we're going to do some fertilizer spreading, and I've already done PK on the arable fields, and we've got some changes as well. I've actually added this new gate in here, which just adds better access really. Which has meant, unfortunately, that we've had to change map over to a new map, and so I've just played around with the foliage in Giant's Editor. So if we check out this, we're going to have to wait for it to update when it goes over to its new... when it goes to the next growth stage, it will update, so we'll have to wait till then, to fast forward time, that sort of thing. Yes, so I think we're going to need to spread N on here, although the moisture will probably go down and along with N as well, and PK and that sort of stuff. So I'll just fast forward the time then, and I will come back when it has all grown and we can see that what the difference is made. Okay, see you in a minute. Right guys, so we're back now, and yeah, so we've got the fertilizer spinner there. Also doing this, the silage has uncovered itself and fully fermented. Nice reasonable large bit. Also the silage bales, they've fermented. But I'm not sure if these ones have. Yeah, they have. Pretty decent quality as well. Yeah. And in the field itself then, obviously gone up a growth stage. Just check here, the moisture is now quite low and the N has decreased. Also PK as well, unfortunately. So we'll have to spread something on there. Actually, it looks like there might be some weeds in the field. Just have a check. Yeah, it looks like some weeds there. Yeah, it's quite high actually, around 30s. Yeah, there's some in there as well. We might have to spread, get a sprayer and spray some sea fertilizer herbicide on it, because that will take barley, wheat and rape, which is, wheat and barley is what we got, sorry, barley and rape are what we got, so that's probably our best bet. I did actually earlier spread some PK on that stubble field, which was a bit of a mistake because we don't need to because it's only stubble, which is at expense, but I guess we can just mean that we don't need to do it later. Yes, so I think we'll have to buy a sprayer then. I'll have to go down to the store to get one. We'll just drop this off. Also, we've filled this up, which is an additional expense, but we'll just have to put it away and use it in the future, I guess, when the moisture's quite high already. If we put it in there, I think we'll just keep the weight on, because I think the sprayer might be a bit too heavy without it. We'll also have to take out a loan because I believe the sprayer is 11 grand. Yeah, and we've got the debt already. We're going to go for the Hardy sprayer. It's a reskin of the original Amazon by GR Modding. And their page and the link to the mod will be in the description. If it's not, just make sure to let me know. I'll have to take out quite a fair loan, actually. Take another one just so that I can afford the fertilizer. So it's this one. It doesn't actually appear as the Hardy in the shop, but it is clearly. Yeah. Let's get attach this up then. So, just want to mention about Ingagri and hiring us, and along with when you get the job back, the quality. Obviously, I don't really like to do this because this is Brompton, it's not Ingagri, but we all know I'm part of it, well, own it, so I guess there's no harm. So, we basically. Currently, we are quite busy, but if you want to hire us, you can send in your job, and we'll give you a date of when we vaguely think we'll be able to do it by. No, start it, sorry. And then if you think it's take too long, then you can just cancel. Otherwise, you just wait that time. And also, with the MP, the way the rakes and tedders work, it does mean that there will be some missed bits that appear to be missed but won't actually be missed. So if we just check, actually just thinking about it, that this is, yeah, it is barley and rape. Didn't want to get that wrong, otherwise we might be spraying the wrong crop, the wrong herbicide. Yeah, so these are the weeds we'll be getting rid of. Not sure whether we'll put a double dose on or just a single, but we'll see. We are back in the minus money, I think. One thing though is that we might want to just check the weather, because the if it rains like or snows like it's there, then we're going to have, it'll mean that, in that will mean that it'll increase the moisture, which is unfortunate. Well, no, it's good, but I think we'll be best off just spraying it again, or spraying it and then with that snow, because it takes 5 days to go to the growth stage, so I won't make too much of a difference, I don't think. Oh, what am I caught on? Oh, it's unfolding. That's Sunday. Oh dear. Just fold that up. Head in then. One of the major advantages of doing it this way is that, as well as the moisture increases, and the herbicide, well, actually, you're less likely to miss or overspray, because you know exactly the width, rather than with the fertilizer spinner, you're not entirely sure, because it spreads it out, although it does give you a slight colouring that you can look at. I'm not sure whether I might need to change it back down to a lower amount, say one or two or something like that, just because because it does seem to take quite a long time to get to the next growth stage. actually, I have just realised that we haven't selected the C, which is what we need. It's on double concentrator B. And B wouldn't accept the rape, although barley would be alright. So we'll just change that over. Sink. Oh, that's a double dose. Yeah. That's the water. Not entirely sure what that is. I think that's kill everything. I think the single dose would probably be the best, because that'll put us on a better money, if you like, because it just changes them, does different costs for different fertilizers or herbicides.
You got all the
You got all the different fertilizers as well with that. So we'll go for single C then. I think that'll be the best bet. We're actually in normal money now. Take this round. Have another go. So, if anyone didn't see it, we at the time of recording this, there was a 12-hour live stream yesterday, being Monday. And if you haven't seen that, then make sure to go and watch the video. Unfortunately, the video only lasted till it was 5 minutes short of the 12 hours. I think the actual video, the actual stream took 12 and a half hours in the end. So those are the last two fields of mowing that are missed in the video. But anyway, we got most of it. I think we'll just spin this off then. I think I might need to actually just stop short in the future. And that's probably a better way than spinning around like that or overspraying, that sort of thing. Stop and then just reverse onto it. I think I'll do that here actually. Might have stopped a bit too short though actually. Yeah, I think that works better. So, carrying on. Sorry for that cut there. We'll just keep spraying this along. Could maybe get into the field slightly more, but I'm not losing anything. Not a great deal, anyway. Back up. Doesn't appear to be using too much fertilizer, the spray actually, which is always good, because then I've got to buy more. But yeah. Also, for those of you that didn't know, got the my second monitor going, which is aiding. This recording, I can have the recording software check it's all open and working properly and that sort of stuff. Also, because it's free, you've only got 10 minutes maximum of one solid recording, so you do have to stop. So the timer on the recording software is useful for that. Not actually taking too long this way. Just probably one more pass this. I think we'll just have to double spray. I'm not sure if you go over twice with this sprayer on a single concentrate. Presumably, that makes it a double concentrate. I'm not too sure, but logically that would make sense. Yeah. Last pass. I think we'll do the next barley field and then one may one rape field, and then we'll end the video there. Just trying to drive the best I can on the crop that's already been uncovered, even though I haven't actually got crop destruction on. But I would like to have crop destruction. It's just that having it means that I've got to swap and change between different versions of drive control, because this is the old version that doesn't have the you don't have to deactivate the shuttle mode, and you don't and you don't, but you, unfortunately you don't have the crop destruction. I just keep this version A useful for the nine to deactivate shuttle, and also because the what's it called? The crop destruction wouldn't be that useful in Gregory. So you have to change all the time. Although we might look into doing it, but just one more thing to remember to change. Pull into this new gate again. I have actually recorded one episode of doing the fertilizer spreading of the PK. But unfortunately, the sound wasn't working correctly on my recording software, so I'm having to do another video. But just means, unfortunately, you don't get to see that last one. But you didn't miss too a great deal. And the next video will probably be the contractors coming in to do the this harvest. I'm not sure whether I'll be trailering or not. I think we'll store this grain and wait for a great demand, although you have actually got to use a tip place trigger to store the rape, because there isn't a storage point on this map. May have been a nice thing for me to add, but when I did my edit, but fortunately not. Yeah, this is not going too bad. Just again, spin back. Really do need to stop him a bit earlier, because I'm actually double spreading it there. But I suppose the double concentrate won't matter. Take the hood off for you. I did get a comment yesterday on the stream. Although sometimes it is useful to have it up. I don't mind about missing the tiniest bit, because not everywhere's going to get weeds anyway. So like now, we are actually missing a bit down the right. It's not the worst bit, but you can have too high moisture if I was to do this again. If I was having to spray this again, because you can flood out the field. But I don't think that's going to be too much of a problem. We'll just go down and do the last field then for this video, and then I'll do the rape one by myself off screen. Do actually need to get a thumbnail as well, but still, I'll do that later. Head on down. This field shouldn't take too long, it's not too big. Although we're having to stop and open gates all the time, I do feel it is better to do it this way, have the gates closed, because when you do finish an activity in real life, you will close up the gates on your way out. Especially as we're actually skipping a whole growth stage. We'll just turn off that sort of mod, I think, as well. Although this field isn't actually too bad at the moment for doing for the weeds, weed content, it is better to do, I think it would probably be better to do it like this and do it beforehand and then just come back. Not sure how long the total recording is. I think it's probably getting on for 20 minute mark. Yeah. This spray is actually quite decent. It looks quite nice, and it's got decent width on it. Works well on this mass, it can handle it well. I know this series is quite different to others, other people have done, I do feel it's not going too bad. The feedback's not pretty good, although I can see that it could get boring with the same tractor all the time and that sort of thing. But you know, a lot of people in real life, especially this size farm, will just have one if they're working alone, so I suppose it's not too unrealistic. I do think soil mod was a good addition to this map, because it's not too big and I could feel that it could get boring. Might just make it remove some boredom, although I think I'll probably end up doing a lot of this fertilizing and spraying off camera, because it is an awful lot. Yeah. So this will come out tomorrow at the time of recording, which is Wednesday. But yeah. Anyway, guys, make sure to like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you in another video. Goodbye, and thanks for watching. Bye.